Hey, I'm Alex, or New Static, and I am the producer for Tauri, and I was just going to show you guys how we use comping in Bitwig. So basically, what I really like about this is we have all of the features of comping that you get from another DAW, but it's all contained within the clip. So essentially, the way that we record is we want to make sure that we can get everything as perfect as possible, so we do a ton of takes, and we just record it over some sort of piano-style instrument. So I've just got a normal acoustic piano here. Solo that. And it's basically just playing the chords from this section. The reason we really only record over a piano is because I like to hear exactly what the vocals sound like so I can have kind of a clearer picture of how I'm going to produce them, or whether I need to double them, or whether I need to add harmonies to a certain section. So I like to record with just piano, just so there's as little in the way of hearing exactly what the actual take sounds like. Essentially, we just record a ton of takes. Right here we have about 12. Basically what I'll do is I'll just listen through this first take and I'll see how this one sounds. So let's go ahead and play this back. Every life I say. Now that's pretty good. And we can already kind of hear a point where we can cut that right before this breath right here, before the second line, where maybe, you know, I don't necessarily love this first take's first line, right? So I can go to my cutting tool or my knife tool by clicking right here, and I'm just going to zoom in, try and find something that looks like a zero point, and make a little cut. So now, essentially, Bitwig will put in the subtle crossfades for you, so you don't really need to worry too much about making sure that there's no clicks or you know, changes in take between these things. But now that I've got the section separated, I can just go ahead and click to select whichever take from these takes that I want. So let's go ahead and listen to this second take, see how we like it. Every life I say. I like that one. Let's see. Every life I say. I like this one a lot, specifically because of the vibrato here. There's some mouth clicking noises, but I can always take that out a little bit later when I'm doing a little bit more in detail editing. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this take. I'm just gonna make sure that we don't have any clicks or pops here in the transition. Mistake of me. That is very clean. That's one of the things I really like about this comping system is you're gonna get, like, honestly, it's just so click to choose a take. Don't worry about anything other than that. I really just like the fact that, you know, I can just kind of continue, pick what's best, and not have to worry about doing all this crazy crossfading or rhythm editing that I would have to do in a lot of other systems. So let's move on to this next line here. Let's see how it sounds. Mistake of me, of me. Let's go ahead and make a cut here right before this next breath. Let's see if, and I can move my cuts around after I've made them, just like that, by clicking and dragging. Let's check out this next take here. Let's see how that sounds. Mistake of me. So I really like this first section here. I think this made in this line is a little bit flat. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make a little bit of a cut right into where this V sibilance is. Essentially, when I'm cutting between words, I try to make it happen on a T or an S or a V or an F, just because it's the sound that's generated by those consonants is a little bit more noise-like, and it makes your crossfades a little bit more transparent. So if you're in the middle of a line and you want to change just one word out, I typically like to do it by cutting around sibilance. So let's make a cut right here in the middle of this V, and let's pick another take, see how this one sounds. Mistake of me. Mistake of me. I like that one actually a lot. So what I'm going to do is you'll notice that we're coming into this take not quite on where the V is, right? It's a little bit, I guess Tauri was starting a little bit earlier here on this word. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go down to the bottom of the take here, our composite, and I'll just move it a little bit. You'll see that my cursor changes down at the bottom, and it lets me just kind of slide this around. So I'm gonna slide it just so like the body of this vowel lands on the beat here. And hopefully these V's will crossfade cleanly and we won't have to do too much from there. So let's listen.
Mistake of made of.
That's great. I think it's a little bit early actually now, or a little bit late now. So I'm gonna drag it back just a little bit more and let's listen to that.
Of many.
Yeah, I think that one sounds really, really good. It's genuinely like such a godsend to have something where I can, you know, slide these around, because in the past I've had to go back to the arrange review and make really detailed, like kind of minor edits. So being able to do this on kind of a detailed level without it affecting how my clip actually looks or how it's arranged, so I can still drag it around as one piece in my arrangement view, is huge. It's just such a lifesaver. So let's move on to this last line of this section here. Let's go back to where to our beginning and just kind of listen to it through, just to refresh ourselves on how it's going so far.
Every life I say, mistake of made, I've made each one for you.
Cool. So one thing I like about this take, and I believe some of the later takes, is we've got on the end of you, she has that extra little note that just gives it a little bit of emotion. So I'm going to make sure that I keep that that note. So let's, if I find a take that I like and it doesn't have that, we'll just come back to this one. We know it's there. So let's try this one a little bit. Let's hear how that sounds.
I've made each one for you.
Yeah, I don't like that one as much. It doesn't have that note, but I actually really like the first chunk of it. So we'll have to bear that in mind.
I've made each one for you.
That one has it, but it's not as strong as that other take. Let's try this one.
I've made each one for you.
And one more.
I've made each one for you.
I actually really like the delicate nature of this take and the way that she hits it here just really subtly. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to keep this section from this last line here. Just make a cut here. Let's see. Yeah, so we're on this F. I'm going to make a cut here. And I'm going to use the first half from this take. Let's see how that sounds. And let's start back here so we can make sure that this take going into this take also sounds clean.
I've made each one for you.
That's pretty nice. Let's try this one.
I've made each one for you.
I actually really like that. I'm stuck kind of between these two takes. Let's see here.
I've made each one for you.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go with this one. It sounds like this section's a little bit late. She gets a little bit behind the beat here. So I'm just going to drag it just a little bit, just like that. And let's see how it sounds.
I've made each one for you.
All right, now my F is getting a little bit weird, so I'm just gonna drag this back just a little bit, just to try and match this, and maybe this crossover point can be right about there. Let's see how that sounds.
One fire.
That's a lot cleaner. So if we go back and we listen to this all the way through, we have our comp vocal.
Every life I say, mistake of made, I've made each one for you.
Awesome. So basically what I would do now is I would go ahead and bounce this out, and I would use the other tools here to make little rhythm edits using the stretch tool, the rhythm is pretty on. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna use this clip gain automation and just bring out some of this point where nobody's singing, maybe bring down the breaths a little bit, just like that. And I would probably, if I was doing a full production right now, I would probably go around just kind of leveling out the words a little bit, just so I have a little bit less work for my compressor to do when I eventually get to the mixing portion of this piece. So essentially what I really like about this system is, again, all of this gain, all of these, any pitch, formant, stretch, audio event stuff that I do inside the clip stays inside the clip and can be bounced out with the clip. So essentially, what I would have to do in another DAW is I'd have to actually use automation for this, and it wouldn't stick with my clip. It would be specific to the track. It would take up a lot more room if I had to have all these comping lanes in my arrangement view. It would just be kind of a nightmare. So essentially, having all of this functionality inside of my actual clip and being recorded there just makes such a monstrous difference in my workflow, because it means I spend less time going to other applications to, you know, do things that take a long time already, like manually de-essing or manually compressing a vocal, which can all be done pretty much right here. And honestly, it's a big part of what makes this software so special to me. All right, so thank you so much for checking out how we handle vocals here in Bitwig 4.0. I'm New Static, working for Tauri. I hope that you've learned a little bit, and I hope it's been a little bit helpful. Have a great day. Keep making beats.